Tali, I know that it's been quite challenging because to go to a hospital in your situation in the middle of this whole coronavirus outbreak, this whole pandemic. How was it for you, Tali?
It was really scary, especially because, you know, like everyone was just rushing to the hospital. Whenever I would go to the hospital for ultrasound treatment, I would see that the emergency room already has a tent outside and there were people outside. So, oh my God, dumadami nang dumadami. Like, they're just getting more and more patients. And
so when you were going inside, you could see a lot of people who were checking in to check if they had COVID-19.
Yeah, they were just in the emergency area. So in Makati Med, the emergency room, kasi when you enter, it's right there. Yes. You know, you don't mingle with them, but you can see it. So it was getting scary, and Justin and I were like, I think the sooner we give birth, the better. So it was a difficult position to be in because coming mom mothers, we want the baby to stay inside your tummy, the longer the better. So ideally 40 weeks and then nothing shorter than that. Hunter was born premature at 33 weeks. I was able to give birth to Sienna at 37 weeks. So it was like, it was difficult, no? But we wanted to give birth sooner, habang wala pang patients, habang hindi pa dumadami yung patients sa hospital. But at the same time, I wanted the baby to stay in my tummy longer because that means that she would develop much better, right? So there. The hospital also came up with a lot of protocols, like your husband cannot be with you in the delivery room.
Wow, but and normally, usually husbands are with their wives in the delivery room, right?
Normally, yeah. Especially, yeah. My procedure was a cesarean section. So with Hunter, Justin was beside me, and then you feel like everyone's operating on you. So it's just so nice to have someone you know beside you. Sure. You're conscious, you're awake. It's not like you're passed out, right? So it's so nice to have someone cesarean beside you.
You're awake pala pag cesarean. I didn't know that. But you didn't want to like pass out and just like sleep, and then when you wake up, your baby's there, na?
I don't think that's a protocol. Parang you have to be awake when they put the baby out, and then after the baby comes out, they make you sleep na while they stitch you up. Yeah. So it's so nice to have someone you know and someone to comfort you, to hold your hand, because it's kind of scary. You have 15. You're lying down there, and then you have 15 people operating on you, and you know you can't feel your legs. You're paralyzed, right, because of anesthesia. So it's just so nice to have someone you know, and the fact that Justin was not allowed to be with me, that really scared me. Parang, who's gonna be in my side, right? Yeah. So, anyway, I had to suck it up. Justin's like, think of your spirit animal. Who's your spirit animal?
And who's your spirit animal, ba?
You know, like a lion cub, a lion mother that takes care of her cub. You know, someone who's fierce. So, parang you can do this. So, sobrang pep talk kami. He would just give me a really, really good pep talk before. You can do this. You know the pedia, you've done this with them 2 years ago. You know the obstetrician. So parang you just pep talk me through it. So what I did was I just brought, when we got married in Italy. So we went to the Vatican after and I bought some rosaries. And I said, you know, on a special day, one day, I will give these rosaries to people. And so sabi ko, okay, this is the time. I brought out those rosaries. And then I brought it with me to the hospital and I gave it to, you know, all the health workers that were with me during the birth. And then I had one rosary like taped up to my hand. Parang that was the only thing that was like, that was with me during the time.